And when I received that information, I was so glad because I write a lot, and also I want to have personal contact with the enemies of the illegal aliens mafia and tell them with my own voice and my own words, because sometimes when I write documents, they read the documents, they get the evidence, but they don't know my personal suffering. They don't know how I feel, how I am affected by the illegal aliens mafia. They don't know that the illegal aliens mafia have sent Esteban Diaz Rivera, an illegal aliens mafia member who assassinates in exchange of welfare benefits that he's not entitled to have for the illegal aliens mafia, who murders citizens upon the illegal aliens mafia request, who is a drug dealer who carries weapons that he cannot carry because he was in jail for about 6 to 7 years, and who has been terrorizing my elderly and chronically ill epileptic mother who is dying of cancer, who whose bones are brittle because of the osteoporosis, who has 3 stomach ulcers, who has 2 leaking heart valves, who has scoliosis and a severe back injury, who suffers from migraine headaches, who has problems with her kidneys and problems with her pancreas, who also has problems with incontinency. Sometimes she cannot wait until she goes to the bathroom to do her necessities. And this woman doesn't have her New York State Trade Medicaid or any legitimate medical insurance. And this woman is about 80 million of USA citizens, like 80 million of USA citizens, is being denied her government benefits and her what is rightly hers, because the illegal aliens mafia has given her government benefits and her identity to illegals, has sold her identity to illegals, and she cannot get cancer treatment for her cancer. She cannot get treatment for her epilepsy. She cannot get medication for her epilepsy because the doctor that she got is an illegal aliens mafia member, Dr. Libu, in Geneseo, New York. She is an illegal aliens mafia member whom I'm pretty sure is using somebody else's identity and somebody else's credentials, because she told me that my mother's nails were being putrefied because of the dilantin that she was swallowing, a medication for epilepsy. The dilantin doesn't putrefy anybody's nails. That's an illness that is called osteoporosis, and it affects your bones, your nails, and other things in you when you have it. My mother has had 2 cancer operations. She cannot get her $345 food stamps after working in this country for dozens of years, paying her taxes, paying into her social security, and doing everything right, because they have to sell her food stamps as part of her as part of a package to illegals, so the illegals can get free government benefits. She cannot use her New York State Trade Medicaid to treat her cancer, her epilepsy, her leaking heart valves, her osteoporosis, or her 3 stomach ulcers, because her New York State Trade Medicaid has been sold to illegals, so they can get free health care. She cannot go to the ophthalmologist or see her eyes. She hasn't been able to see her ophthalmologist or get something for her eyes in about 7 years or so, because illegals are getting free vision care. She cannot get her dental care. She cannot swallow or eat well, or even speak well, because her dentures are faded so much that she cannot do these things, because illegals using her identity have dental care of excellent quality. So is this fair? This is not fair. And this is a chronically ill citizen, and we have millions, M-I-L-L-I-O-N, millions of USA citizens who are like my mother, worked to death in this country with no government benefits because they are sold to illegals, and with no help whatsoever, and just waiting for death to arrive, while illegal aliens mafia members who are assassins for the illegal aliens mafia in exchange of government benefits and welfare benefits, like Esteban Diaz Rivera, are young and strong, and they work on the side for cash payments and earn $500 to $1,000 per week fixing cars like Mercedes, Audis, and BMWs, getting $500 to $1,000 per week, getting Section 8, which they sold and rented to get extra money, getting senior citizens' apartments, which they also rent to get extra money, selling drugs on the street and getting extra money, and getting on top of all that, are you ready for this? On top of all that, these illegal aliens mafia members who are 33 years old, like Esteban Diaz Rivera, get home attendants to go to their homes, smoke marijuana with them, drink with them, and falsify documents so they can have a good time and tell the taxpayer, oh, this person needs a home attendant because he's disabled. While in reality, he goes to party all the time and comes back. He leaves at 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock at night, and he comes back at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 o'clock in the morning, drunk and drugged. These are the people, the prototype of the illegal aliens mafia. These are the people who the taxpayers are supporting full cover, that free medical care, free housing, free clothing, free furniture, money, money in cash, tenos. These are the people who are receiving our hard work and our taxes money and enjoying life. And he told me himself that he goes to a casino and he gets home attendants just to have a good time without the home attendants doing anything much, because, quote unquote, the government pays for that. The taxpayers pay for that. I don't pay for that. So is this a way for a society to function? We will never get out of debt. Never. If the illegal aliens mafia is not dismantled, we will never get out of debt.
In fact, now this brings me to the next point right now that I really wanted to also address in my notes. Some of you guys out here, like I said, you may not be in the position where my sister or Solange's mother is, both chronically ill women with serious health concerns. And I know some of you are thinking, well, I know that my doctors may hurt me, but, you know. Let me tell you another angle how they also get money. If some of you have had theft of your land, theft of your house, that would be real estate. They'll go for that. They take your job. They're going to take, how about this, if you got a, like me, a sorry pension, but a few years off from a decent pension, somebody's living off of that right now. What I'm saying is there's so many avenues when they take us as victims or slaves or whatever they call us. It's all about, the name of the game is about money. So after I go and try to get your government benefits, if you own a house, I'm going to take that away, absorb that. That's a lot of money. I'm going to take your land. I'm going to take your credentials. I got a college degree. Someone's working with mine. I probably barely got out of sixth grade. I'm going to take everything for you and leave you nothing. So a lot of us can be younger out there, but if we think about it, hey, I did have a bad move at that condo I tried to buy, or they're trying to steal my house. It's all about money. So if they take it dramatically, like Solange talked about, they'll also go for every asset you have. And then, remember, they're friends, these are criminals. Then this is how they cross-reference, they intersect when they meet voyeurism for women, rape, kitty porn. Criminals may not run the same game, but criminals know each other. They always have.
And another thing that we forgot to mention, if you have a job, still, if you have a job, because you won't have it for long, I guarantee. The illegal aliens are coming into our countries. They need your social security number and they need your identity to buy houses so they can rent it to other illegals and citizens, and to give part of the rent money to the DSS department and the ASA department. I mean, Social Security Administration Office and the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services employees. But if you still have a job, they will work with your Social Security number and your identity. They will not pay taxes. And guess what? If they owe taxes upon taxes with your name and Social Security number, pretty soon the IRS is going to come looking for you. So if you are stopped for a traffic violation, let's say, and somebody else is using your identity and they haven't been paying taxes for the last 10 years or so, and they owed like $10,000 in taxes, guess who is going to get arrested?
Okay. And then also, you guys, think about that too. Always try to, when they come in and bang on your doors, falsely arrest you, you stopped at a traffic stop, want to arrest you, put you in a mental illness, they want to criminalize us like crazy so they can lock us up in jail and throw away the key.
Yes, that's why I tell everybody, when you are faced with a police officers or the justice system's department employees or illegal alias mafia members from DSS employees or from SSA, Social Security Administration offices, or from Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services, record your conversation or have somebody else, have a microphone somewhere hidden or have a camera somewhere hidden, or have somebody else, record them, and do not please them. Let them insult you. Let them tell you off. Let them tell you that your mother is a loose woman, that she was on the street. She's a street walker. Let them say and do whatever they want.
Did someone say that? Wait, someone say that about your mother?
They have
horrible things.
Yes, they have told me so many things, and I stay quiet. You know why I stay quiet? Because I have to let them behave the way they truly are, and they are criminals. When they behave that way and I record them, when I report them, I say, look at the way they behave. Is this the way a government employee is supposed to behave? I had government employees.
I don't want to interrupt one thing, Solange. I want everyone to hear this real quick, because you know what? All jokes and all, you know, kidding aside, you guys, when you have that recorder on, that's your lucky charm in your back pocket. I, too, will stay very quiet, because you want to give them enough rope to fuck themselves, really.
Yes,
you got the recording on.
Exactly.
You don't have to worry about it, guys. No, this ain't no argument. You don't have to get ghetto. Let them
behave like criminals. Like the way they are.
They're criminals.
We can
feel it when we go to agencies. We can feel it when we look around at our banks, our federal, state, local agencies, our cops. Look at it. I'm not trying to make everyone paranoid, but look at them. Aren't they? It's more than just unprofessional. You wonder who hired this idiot.
Yes, illegal alias mafia members who want somebody there to abuse and subjugate the citizens who worked hard all their lives and pay taxes for their government benefits and identities to be stolen and sold to illegals.
Let's again recap, because I want to make sure I'm going just a little slower, and repeat, I wanted to burn in everyone's short term to go into your long term memory, okay? So, President Trump has a new governmental agency. It's less than 90 days old. It's called VOICE, and it stands for Victims of Immigration and Crime Engagement. They have a hotline number where you can call, and if you want to, you can verbally put your complaint in. It is 855-48-VOICE, 855-48-VOICE. I'm sure you have to dial a 1 first, but I That's a good route, and they are being trolled. I think the word, I think that's perped in my language, but this new agency's hotline is being trolled by these trolls that are using the line to say, to report aliens and to talk about Lost in Space episodes. It's a waste of time, basically. But if you can get through, because I'm going to call it, you guys, think it through. I want my name and all of our names for the resistance so known that we're on Facebook, any in-house, out-house knows our name, what time it is, in, up and down the internet. We don't have nothing to lose. I'm not trying to invoke fear, but these illegals working with homegrown Americans want our identity and they want to kill us so they can step into the life. They've taken everything, but we are at risk right now just breathing.
Exactly, exactly.
And if you don't think, and it's trafficking, and if you don't think a trafficker sees this prey as a thing, I'm glad to get played for it. And then I believe this is how, I think this is the large, one of the larger money makers, because remember, mafia members are in your media. We know they're in your medical, that's hospitals, doctors, banks, with their antitrust fraud, credit card fraud. They're in the post office. They're even in the White House. Senators, Congress. Our last commander-in-chief got a nice pocket of cash.
Can you imagine?
And the entire influx is coming in for illegal aliens and from the Middle East and from Mexico. That's the highest numbers. Look around and they can circumvent our subversives. They turn quality neighborhoods into slums almost overnight. Would they watch us, follow us, degrade us, victimize us, even if we want to pull off to a seaside restaurant and a hotel? I don't even enjoy those kind of day trips anymore. I don't know. Am I going to be burned, attacked, watched, poisoned by the food?
Exactly. And I have been all of the above. I went to a pizza place once, and they gave me a pizza that had something in it, and I got so sick, you would not believe. And then the person that I went with, whom I'm sure was in it, she's an illegal alias mafia member. Then they did that the same thing to her, and I was so glad that they did it to her, because many illegal alias mafia members think that just because they are illegal alias mafia members, they are immune to the illegal aliens mafia criminality, and they're not. Those in a mafia, you will find criminals, and criminals betray each other. They don't trust each other, and they do things to each other to look for their best interest. Everybody's looking out for himself or herself, and they have no morals, and they have no love for thy neighbor, none whatsoever.
No, and I want to bring something else in. All of you guys are grown, because I'm 55, I'm grown. We just have to say it. Men and women listening right now, watch yourself. If you're single, I know how it is. We GIs get a little lonely or whatever. They gonna try to throw some kind of honeypot at us. Some woman that, you know, the type you would be attracted to if you're if the mafia is smart. Same thing with the women. They're going to throw a guy in your face, you know, looking like the kind of guys you would, you know, back in the day, you would be attracted to. Do not dance around if you feel like this is a mafia member or perp. These people will do it with anybody. They probably got a nasty man or a nasty woman's disease. They all have herpes. They're already killing us. Some of us are being hit by directed energy weapons.
And they will sell their mother for a quarter.
Oh, yeah, that's right. If they come in from those exotic countries and say, oh, you don't know where the fuck they've been, you know?
Yes.
They have, most of them have herpes because they said it already in Hollywood. Most of them, if you want to, you know, get it out of your mind with Kim Kardashian. She got herpes too. All of them do.
And you know what? When they come here illegally, they don't check them for tuberculosis, herpes, or any other illnesses. They just say, come in right now, take your USA passport, and take your social security number. And that's it. And take your food stamps card. And once they have that, they can go any place within the United States. with the food stamp card and with the USA passport or the social security number, they are not limited to the place where they assign them when they come in. They can leave the place any time, and they can go around and do whatever they want. So don't think that just because they come in and they are going to be placed in a place as refugees or as, you know, newcomers, they're going to stay there, because they won't.
And you guys need to really catch up on this. They have permeated every stratosphere of our country. They're in the big cities, sanctuary cities, if you want to call them, but they're also in small town America. And I do feel that anyone that is willing, and they are willing, to kill us, we're in danger. And it saddens me, but it's true. Very, very important, powerful people have sold off the people. I don't know everything about President Trump, but by his actions, if it's 100 days, I'm not going to lie, I'm blown away by his industry. This man has, and his team has worked, and I ain't seen that in decades. So if all of these Democrats or whoever else is just hating on him, you're just jealous because he got in there, rolled his sleeves up, and got to work. We've had nothing but a bunch of sloth and laziness in this country for the last 40 or 50 years. But all of us as victims right now, or TIs, is interchangeable. We did nothing wrong. We wanted to work, produce a society, law-abiding, good people. We don't deserve this crap that they're doing to us. And these criminals with this mafia, they have an angle of making money, but trust. They also know the other part of the mafia that's all down for that voyeurism, kitty porn, woman rape. They tell them even raping the men. Human trafficking is just that, you guys, trafficking.
And remember, the Department of Social Services sells children to children pedophiles, and other people. And I have, by the way, evidence to prove this. I have recordings of people confessing to children abuse and the documentation that proves that the Department of Social Services falsified documents, omitted tests, and falsified legal records to sell children to children pedophiles. For example, a man putting a 6 months old baby to suck his breast, 6 months old little girl, putting that girl on his nipples to suck his nipples. A 1 year old.
Yes.
Yes.
So
and I have seen judges telling people, how much can you give me for the custody of the child? They will sell the custody of the child to children pedophiles, to people who live, the same man that I'm talking about left a six-month-old little girl with one diaper from 7 o'clock in the morning to 7 o'clock at night, and said that she doesn't need to be changed more than once per day. 6 months old. Her buttocks were virtually cooked from the urine and the excrement that her buttocks experienced, because he was selling the diapers that the week and the milk and other the other things that the government gave the child. He would send it to Santo Domingo, the Dominican Republic, and sell it there, or give it away to his girlfriends and other women. They will also get turnoff in cash money and for the children, and also give cocaine to the children in the milk to damage the brains, because the children, 6 months old and 1 year old, they cannot, their brains cannot process the cocaine, so their brains are damaged. In addition to that, this man that I'm talking about, by the name of Francis Morillo, he's Dominican. He had a police filed in the Dominican Republic, but he paid people in the police department there to remove it so he can come to the United States and milk the government for money, defraud the USA government. He abuses children to damage their brains because the children with the brains damaged are worth the most in welfare. So if a child gets welfare benefits and it's a normal child, they might give you maybe $1,000 per month, but if it's a damaged child with a damaged brain, they can give you Social Security disability plus a full cover welfare. They can give you up to $3,000 for a child or more with damaged brains. So these illegal aliens mafia members are not only criminals, they are dehumanized criminals, and they do not have a conscience. They do whatever they want. They see people and children as things, not as human beings. And this, the Department of Social Services across the country, they sell the children, because I have seen it with my own eyes, and I have also collected the evidence. So if anybody wants to see it, let them contact me directly, 914-619-8362. I will show you the evidence.
Excuse me, Professor Martinez, let's put the phone number down a little quieter and I'll put it in the chat.
914-619-8362, 914-619-8362. And also you can contact me at my Facebook account, www.facebook.com/Solange.Martinez.5817.
Thank you, Professor Martinez. I had a feeling when I first made contact with you that these brackets that we have been put into overlap each other. The name of the game is money. Criminals know each other even if they don't play the same game. And they're after a new victim, or they call it, you know, a mark, suckers. You know what I mean? It's dehumanizing all the way around.
They do anything for money, and I mean anything for money.
Anything. I'm telling you guys, I wouldn't touch them with a 10-foot pole. Now, when they move in around your houses or apartments, they're going to try to look like normal people. They're going to cut the grass. They're going to really hang out that American flag. Watch the American flags, because I don't know what that means, but something off about them when you really think about it. I can't put it into words. I'm kind of creepy about them. And they give you an icky feeling. I don't know what it is. Maybe they're trying too hard to blend in, but they just don't blend in.
And also, the authorities that are seeing this abuse against American citizens by illegal aliens mafia members and by the illegal aliens mafia, they play the same game that they played with journalists and lawyers. Ann Coulter. They say, well, you know, this man is raping these children and abusing them sexually and otherwise in every way, shape, and form, but we, the police, cannot do anything, and we, the district attorney, cannot do anything, and we, the detectives, cannot do anything. I had a New York City detective, which was a woman, by the way. Don't think that women are less despicable than men, because it's not that way. A detective who was a woman, a Hispanic woman, told me that she couldn't go and arrest these criminals that were abusing the children, because she went to their house and they were not there. So that means if this detective has a daughter or a grandchild or a sister and somebody rapes them, if she goes to arrest them or to investigate, she's going to close the case because the persons, the criminals are not there. This is what she wants us to believe.
Oh my God.
It is ridiculous the way they look at you and cynically tell you that they're not going to do anything regarding what they can do a lot about. Like they told Ann Coulter, when her speech about immigration, illegal immigration, was canceled because people were afraid, her sponsors were afraid, and people were afraid, and she was afraid, frankly, to go to a place because the illegal aliens mafia threatened with destroying the place. And by the way, who do you think is paying for that? Because these people are not going to, these criminals are not going to go to a place and destroy the place, break the windows, break the cars, burn the vehicles for free. They are receiving a lot of money, and I wonder who do you think is paying for that, and who do you think is giving them money? The illegal aliens mafia and the illegal aliens mafia members who have access to the money from the top, the welfare department commissioners, the SSA commissioners, and the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services, who are which are making a lot of money of the citizens and by selling the citizens' identities and government benefits. You can be sure that these criminals who go to destroy private property and intimidate the citizens so they don't tell anybody that the immigration laws have to be enforced for our citizens to survive, these criminals have a full cover welfare package, and they have a full cover government benefits and other people's government benefits too. So if we dismantle this illegal aliens mafia, it's going to be for the benefits of all the United States citizens, because that leak of money is billions and trillions upon billions and upon trillions of money that is being given to illegals and illegal aliens mafia members, to these social parasites, and to do nothing but destroy our society. And these doctors and nurses and hospital staff that are abusing our citizens, they're not doing that for free. They are giving a lot of money to do that, and they are giving a lot of money to continue to sell, to steal the citizens' social security numbers and citizens' personally identifiable information, and sell them to illegals in our country. So you think that you are dealing with honest, decent people at the hospitals and at the judicial system department, at our police department, and you are dealing with criminals who do not care about the security of our children, of our citizens, or the security of our disabled citizens and of our elderly. They care about money, M-O-N-E-Y. That's all they care about.
Very disgusting. Is there anything, Professor Martinez, that you'd like to add in tonight, or are you interested in some questions that some of the audience may have for you?
The only thing that I want to continue to remind the audience is that we have to fight back and remember God is in control. So continue to fight back, continue to read your sacred scriptures, and continue to pray, because if you prayed and you fight back and you continue to read the sacred scriptures, the illegal aliens mafia members are not going to defeat you. Even if they subjugate you, curse you out, or tell you that you're nothing, that you're garbage, they're not going to defeat you. Trust me.
No, and what I really want everyone to know, I know with our targeting, they want us to be tired, exhausted. Some of us are hit again with weapons that we really are physically ill, in our beds a lot snowing. They will do anything and everything to keep you from calling the 855-48-VOICE or putting in your complaint. It's so important to not only have your paper trail of when you're treated crazy from doctors or illegally evicted, to cross, you know, kind of to cross your teeth and dot your I's, but also you've got to still reach out with that and either mail a copy or scan a copy to the illegal aliens' enemies. See, because when we don't, like, do nothing, we're giving them, like, a green card to go ahead and keep stalking us and killing us. And, I mean, I could die in 3 hours from now, but until every breath of me, you want your victimization known as much as possible. Some of you that are really good, even with the internet, can scan it, have it on Facebook or YouTube. we ain't taking this lane down, because all we need to know right now is that before we were TIs or victims, we were working, productive American citizens that did nothing wrong. It is this someone with invisible chains. It doesn't have to be like Kunta Kinte in the Roots episode where the physical net was over him, but it is a net that we have been put in, that we didn't ask for it, we don't want it, and I want people to pay. These are crimes against humanity. You want to call it subversive groups, hate groups, illegal alien mafias. They're all subversive. They're all crimes against humanity. They're no different than Nazis. They're all the same. Traffickers are Nazi. One way or the other, they're subversive against humanity. Does anyone have any questions or comments at this time for Professor Martinez? A lot of information was shared. We are covering it, but we want very much to, we want you guys all on board to understand this racket. I believe that we're victims of a lot of racket.
And
we don't know all the players. Yeah, I think there's a lot of rackets over. But this one in particular wants our identity.
Also, don't think that if you have children, you're immune to being abused, because you haven't had any problems with the Department of Social Services or Centers for Medicare, Medicaid Services, or SSA. Because, as I said before, any illegal aliens mafia member that doesn't like you or thinks that you are hateful because you went to college or you studied and he or she didn't do that, so they hate you because of that, for some type of pathological reason. If any illegal aliens mafia tells the mafia to falsely arrest you, they will. They will find a place to, they will find an excuse to falsely arrest you. And they will fabricate the charges. They will falsify legal records. And I have seen all that in my 15 years of research. And if you think that they're not going to, if an illegal aliens mafia member doesn't like you and tells the Department of Social Services to fabricate things about you, to take away your child and give it to illegal aliens mafia members for them to receive welfare benefits while they take your children and rape them and abuse them in every way possible, they will do that. Only an illegal aliens mafia member has to tell his or her friends from the Department of Social Services, that child, we can do business with the children of that person or with the children of this person. And we can fabricate this, and we can say that he or she abuses the children, and we can take the children, put them in my house or in my sister's house, and get lots of welfare benefits while they are in our house until they find out that nothing happened. And then we will say, oh, sorry, we just had a suspicion, so we had to remove the child. They will do all that, and don't think that they will not. I have seen many illegal aliens mafia members receiving $3,000 per month for one child that they removed from supposedly a place where the child was abused, only to be placed in foster care, to be abused and beaten up by illegal aliens mafia members. I know a woman by the name of Elena Escalante. She lived in the Bronx for many years. She's a child abuser. She beat the heck out of a child that was approximately 8 years old, a Chinese child that didn't even speak Spanish because he was Chinese. They gave it to her. She doesn't speak English or Chinese. And she beat the heck out of the child just because she went. She took the child to a store, and the child was doing something and went a few steps away from her, and she didn't see it right away. she beat the hell, the back, the hell, she beat the heck out of the child, and she was receiving $3,000 just to let him sleep in her house and give her, give the child some food. That's all. And there are millions of illegal aliens mafia members who are doing that. Millions. If you think that you are not in danger because you haven't had any contact with DSS or SSA or Centers for Medicare or Medicaid Services or the police officers who are working for the illegal aliens mafia, because they have teams. The mafia, this mafia has teams of police officers all over the country in each prison, police prison. Don't think that you are immune. They will get to you. They haven't, if they haven't done so, or if you haven't discovered that they are using your identity and your government benefits yet, they will get to you, I guarantee. And by the way, I have some agencies or businesses that I didn't mention before, which I'm going to post in the under the businesses controlled by the mafia. Of these are businesses that take care of children supposedly, and they hire nannies. When in reality, they go through the paperwork of the citizens. They place ads on the on the newspapers and also in the internet. And when the citizens, the legal citizens and legal residents reply to the ad advertisements, they are interviewed, their licenses and driver licenses number and social security numbers and personally identifiable information is taken by these agencies, and then they turn around and give these jobs or sell these jobs to illegal aliens who are criminals, and guess who are the ones that they sent to work as babysitters and as nannies for the American citizens who are working hard during the day and want to come home to a nice babysitter or a nice nanny after paying $800, $900 per week for a nanny. These are the agencies that do this. Babysitterforhire.com, babysitterforhire.com, careforhire.com, college nannies and tutors, e-nannies, gonannies.com, nannies for hire, and getnannyjobs.com, Thumbback, which is a tutoring company, THUM as in Mary, B as in boy, TACK, TACK, and others that I have recorded during my 15 years of research. And other companies that are like Verizon, illegal aliens mafia controlled, that provide internet services is Net Zero, and as I said before, Cablevision in New Jersey, and also another illegal aliens mafia connector or illegal aliens mafia controls business is the Ibero American Action Action League, and the phone number is 585-256-8900. And that's upstate New York. That's one of the agencies that tells the citizens, if you want some government benefits, you have to say that you have mental illnesses, because the mental illnesses programs are the ones that have the most money and we can work with. So say that you are mentally that you have mental problems, even if you don't, and you sign some papers for us saying this. And we can get you some government benefits, when in reality you're going to sign the papers for them, which is a fraud, because if you don't have an illness, you cannot say that you have it. And after you commit fraud, they will practice extortion on you and threaten you and give you nothing. So this is the type of organization that this is in, that this is that is connected to the illegal aliens mafia. And this organization is works with donations of people. So a lot of people are giving thousands upon hundreds of thousands of dollars for this organization to supposedly help American citizens and legal residents from Latin America and other places. And in reality, they have a corrupted agency that commits fraud and steal money from the taxpayers to fill up the employees' pockets and falsify documents. That's all it is for.
Okay. Wow. Again, a lot to take in. Again, before we start asking the questions, I can't, how do I say this? Let's say it. We're laying out the information, the things you need to do. If you require help, we can help you. But, and I want all of you to hear this real clear.